who will be talking to us about being kind.
Confucius, the great Chinese philosopher, once said, "Wheresoever you go, go with all your heart." But what does this actually mean? Well, to me, I believe that this means that whatever you do, you give it your all, with all your heart. No matter the outcome, you do it because you want to, not because you have to. Please take a moment and take a look at our video.
Sometimes I lay under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday.
All my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for.
just saw was an example on how kindness can transcend from student to student, from GPA to our community. I want to tell you a story about a woman. Every day, this woman would have spare change to give to a homeless man that sat on the street corner every evening. What caught this woman's attention was the fact that every day she would ask this man, "How are you feeling? Is there anything new?" And his reply would always be the same, "I'm blessed." Although she knew what his answer would be, she would still ask him regardless. Now one day, this woman was called to her boss's office at work, and she was told that she would be getting laid off due to the economy. A feeling of worry and depression engulfed her as she drove home that evening. Thoughts such as, "How will I provide for my kids? How will I pay my rent? How will I find another job?" came across her mind, leaving her hopeless. So as she approached that familiar corner that night, she hoped for a green light. But that same man was already walking over to her car. As he approached her window, she said with a hopeless tone, "I've just lost my job, and I have nothing to give." With a gracious smile, he hands the woman a dollar and tells her, "Everything will be fine." This man did not just give her a dollar that day, but he gave her hope. A man who has nothing but a smile and the clothes on his back gave back what was freely given to him: love, hope, and compassion. Ladies and gentlemen, I want all of you to remember that you can be the one to make that change.
For 25 weeks, my partner and I have ventured off into many exciting areas located around the San Diego community. Good morning, everyone. My name is Honorio.
And my name is Darian Lindley. And welcome to our senior talk.
Picture can speak 1,000 words. We wanted to develop pictures about our community to capture the beautiful moments of life. It is because a picture can create a movement, can create a vision and deep desire to give back and really enjoy life.
Well, we wanted to bring this phrase to life. We took several trips to Balboa Park to capture beautiful moments in the heart of San Diego. We didn't keep it to just San Diego, however. It all began with a road trip, which turned into an adventure. Mr. Bent, a mentor of ours, invited us along with Director Riverall to meet a world-famous by the name of Ricardo. It felt great to see someone design sculptures with such passion. He was even kind enough to let us allow his location in Temecula. Fun fact about Ricardo Bracetta: most of his sculptures are inspired by the movie Jurassic. Heard of it? Well, on our way back, stop at an elementary school we have never seen nor heard of. What captured our attention was the commotion in front of the school. There were countless cars and flickering lights. We stopped for a little adventure. Take a look at this picture of our director standing in front of their main office.
It looked like something straight out of a Hollywood movie.
As I was saying, there were elementary students who had no idea who we were, yet they allowed us to witness their amazing play that was going on that day. And on top of all that, they gave us cake and lemonade. It felt great to see some acts of kindness coming from children a lot younger than us.
It really did feel great.
We have learned so much this year, seniors. A lot of math, English, history, Thanks, Ms. Upper, wherever you live. But most importantly, we have learned a lot from the director's college class. He taught us about how and when to love. What's stopping you from making a change in your life? Good question. I've asked that same thing to myself. How can I show compassion and kindness without expecting anything in return?
Simple, Darian. You have to want to make a change. I don't know if any of you are aware of this, but there's a huge problem in today's society. There is not enough kindness in this world. Am I right? Surround ourselves with positive people. People who will bring joy into our lives. Director Rivera once said, "You are the sum of the five people we spend the most time with." And also, for eight years, according to the San Diego Union Tribune, for 8 years, the crime rate in San Diego has been the same. Did you know this just in? As Pablo said yesterday, that there are 53 undocumented gangs in just the 92102 zip code. But the love, kindness, that has been instilled within our school community has made an impact outside the four fences of our school. We are beating all stereotypes and have graduated 100% and making our way to college. I believe we can be the change in our community simply by being respectful, being supportive, being considerate, being helpful, being honest, and most importantly, everyone, being kind.
Mother Teresa once said, spread love everywhere you go. Let no one come to you without leaving you happier. How are people leaving your company? Are you the kind of person to lift somebody up or to bring somebody down? The director taught us an extremely valuable lesson. He taught us about the six different kinds of love that we can't define, and when is the appropriate time to exemplify them. So today we would like for all of you to focus on agape, the love for everyone. The reason for this is because we want everyone to understand what it means to have love for the people around you, regardless if you know them or not. With that being said, I want to share a story with all of you. Take a look at this Fuji face. I want to tell you a story on how I overcame my meanness. I wasn't aware how mean I was until I couldn't be mean anymore. Probably doesn't make any sense, but let me tell you. One morning, I woke up, I was pretty mad, you know? Happens. I was agitated. I thought the world was out to get me. And I carried this attitude along with me to school. Bad idea. It's the happiest place here on earth. It's Disneyland. Come on. So a teacher comes along and she asks me, is everything okay? I brush her off, you know, push her away, tell her, everything's fine. She explained to me that she was only there to help. Yeah, I saw it totally different. During the entire situation, I wasn't ready to make a change. I let my pride get to the best of me. And I let my guard up. One of the most loving teachers here at Gompers. Oh, I was mean, I tell you. I was mean. I was like the night before Christmas. I gave tricks, no treats. Just saying. Anyways, though, I was truly embarrassed, all in all. One of the most loving teachers here at GPA had to endure my negativity. It was awful. Mrs. Robinson, if you're here, please take a stand. I just want to let you know that you've driven me to become a better person as well as student, although you may not know that. So thank you. Why are people mean? Well, I've asked that same question for my high school career. However, not enough times to make a change. I know what some of you are thinking. You know what? These guys up here have a point. I should be a lot more nice. But that isn't enough. You, I want you, and the rest of the people behind you to pledge right now that you'll be a kinder person. Same goes for you and you. I want all of you here to pledge that you'll become a nicer person. Don't just tell yourselves. Based off of research, it has been proven that most audiences tend to forget the information a few hours after. So write it down, come on.
When you walked in today, you should have received a brochure. We want you to read and analyze this brochure. If you truly believe what it stands for, we want you to put these practices into place. Pledge that you'll become a better person. Pledge that you will devote yourself to love, kindness, and compassion. Simply by being nice, you can change your lives and make an impact on others.
So right now, I want to do something pretty dangerous. I dare all of you right now. No. I double dare you. How about that? Give them apples. Turn around right now to your neighbor or the person behind you and tell them, you will have an awesome day.
Awesome day. No, you. You. You will have an awesome day.
Okay. All right. I get it. Oh, I have an awesome day. I love that. When we feel, or no, when we experience love, we not only feel peace, but in order to love, you must first learn how to love yourself. That is the key to everything. Remember that. Oh. Unfortunately, Muhammad will not be able to be here with us today, but we would like to acknowledge his achievement and dedication. With that being said, Mr. Benz, we would like for you to honor him. Please come up here and take a check that will be going towards his Harvard trip this summer.
I would like to read you a story called, Are You My Mother? This is a very personal story to me that tells the recent events in my life. Once upon a time, there two half-sleeves. The mother left her two eggs, never to come back again. When the birds hatched, they did not understand where their mother went. So the birds waited, day and night, through lonely, stormy nights. One sunny morning, the sister of the mother bird wanted to pay her a visit. To her surprise, she found two hatchlings, cold, lonely, and hungry. Her spirit immediately kicked in. She took the hatchlings to her nest. The sister bird loved them, fed them, and provided for their every need. Over time, the sister bird continued to care for them and treated them as her own. The sister bird's love for them grew deeper and deeper. The sister bird gave all that she had to the birds. She even went without so that they could have. The baby birds felt her love, compassion, and kindness. They began to call her mother because, in fact, that was the only mother that they knew. One day, the sister bird grew ill and continued to care for the two hatchlings. Over time, she lost most of her feathers, but still continues to care for the two hatchlings. Their mother became weak and unable to care for the birds. The birds, still in the nest, thought to themselves, what's going to happen? Although she never gave up, the sister bird became weaker and weaker, and eventually took her last breath, gone from their lives. The questions now became overwhelming to the birds. Who's going to feed us? Who's going to take care of us? Who's going to teach us how to fly? The two young birds in the story are about me and my brother. After my mom's sister, who raised us, recently passed away, my brother and I started asking, who's going to teach us how to fly? As weeks passed by, we both realized she has taught us everything we need to know in order to fly. Compassion, love, and kindness. She made the best of what she had and gave everything that she could. Every day when I would come home from school, I would see her sitting on the corner of her couch, having coffee with my aunt, uncle, cousin, or family friend. Her house was always open to anyone. It reminds me of her open arms and open heart. Her compassion, love, and kindness was felt by everyone. Her compassion, love, and kindness something I want to share with you. I shared this story with you because my mother, who passed away, the one like the bird who taught me how to give love, compassion, and kindness. And because of her, I will continue to live her legacy of being kind.
Thank you, Honorio, for sharing your mother's legacy with all of us. I want all of you to remember to be kind every day to everybody. That being said, thank you, and this concludes our senior talk.